For Mackindoe, the failure of the relationship could be even worse than the failure of an individual graft, as the former had far greater long-term implications for the patient. At all times, it must be borne in mind that it is one thing to cure the patient of his disfigurement and deformity. It is another to carry through such an arduous program and end up with a normal human being. Throughout the surgical period and for long after it, the patient will lean heavily on the surgeon for mental support, for hope and encouragement. If the relationship deteriorates, trust and confidence will disappear, and the progression which should characterize the particular plan will also disappear. Above all, it was his definition of what constituted a successful reconstruction that marked out the unique quality of his approach to his patients. The surgeon should always remember that eventually, any real and lasting satisfaction which this kind of work affords is derived from his own interest in what the patient does with what the surgeon achieved, rather than from the purely technical aspect of the repair. This, then, was the philosophy of the surgeon who was entrusted by the RAF with its most gravely injured servicemen. But he asked much of them in return. Once he had secured the best possible medical environment in which reconstruction could take place, he set out with equal energy to secure the wider social and service environment, regarding it as being of equal therapeutic importance as the recovery ward and operating room. There was, however, only one element in the Burns treatment infrastructure of any significance that was not initiated by Archibald Mackindoe. 1 year after the Battle of Britain, a handful of people foregathered in a small hut in the grounds of East Grinstead,